We're going to show you the differences between having an old dog and a young dog. This is a day in the life. And if you can hear that crying, it sounds like we're starting the day with a young dog.
Good morning.
Yes.
Yep.
This is what a morning is like with a younger dog. Oh, hello.
So the morning pet's a little bit more crazy. The first thing we always do is go on a morning walk. But before we do that, you may be thinking, this is not a younger dog. Well, here's some fun facts on Moki. Although she looks like a mini horse, she is only 12 months old, 7 in human years. So yes guys, she is still a puppy. She's got zero chill and wants to play 24/7. And also whines during the day when she's tired because she just refuses to go to sleep. And this seems like a good time to introduce our older dog. Here's Kobe. Kobe is 4 years old, turning 5 in a few months. So that's 28 in human years. And I know, you're probably thinking, that's not an old dog. But trust me, when I say he acts about 78, he's the most chilled out dog ever. Sleeps pretty much the whole day, doesn't like toys, and also prefers his alone space.
And this is what a morning with an older dog looks like. Are you smiling? A lot more chilled out, a lot more peaceful. Should we go on your morning walk? Why are you pulling that face? Oh, big stretch. Life of an older dog.
Now you've gotten to know the dogs, let's see the differences in their morning walks.
Collar on, halter on. Oh, big yawn. Sit.
Sit, Moki, sit. Good girl.
And this is another thing with having a younger dog. They can't sit still for longer than 2 seconds. Collar. A lot easier to put things on him. He's going to stay in place, not move anywhere. Oh, good boy.
So we're currently in the process of lead training Moki, but being a young puppy, she goes absolutely crazy. So for now, we've got the halter that just works for us. Kobe, on the other hand, is super chilled out. We just have a slip lead on him so that he knows what direction we're walking in.
Yes!
So this is actually a brand new walk that she's never gone on before. So we know she's gonna have a good time. Get up, Moki! Find it. Come on, Mokes. Good girl, there you go. So we've got to make sure she's as tired as possible at the start of the day or else we'll get no work done. This dog has got endless energy. And so we've got to make sure she is tired. All right, you want a stick? Go on then. Crazy dog. And if we're short on time, we've got a little trick up our sleeve. The best thing about having two of us is that we can do this. Moki, come. Come on.
Moki, come.
Moki!
It's working, she's getting tired. She's like, who, me?
We decided to take Kobe on the same walk. Again, he's never been here before. You can see he's a lot more chilled out on walks, taking his time, sniffing the ground, taking it all in, really. You love it, don't you, Kobe? Oh, you're such a good boy.
You're such a good boy.
Ah, I can have a nap. Yeah, it's just a bit more peaceful with this one. But now it's time to go home and feed them their breakfast. This is where you see how patient an older dog is compared to a younger.
Moki, it's time to go home! It's time to go home! Come here! Come here!
There's two main differences when you have an older dog and a younger dog when it comes to feeding time. Number one, the older dog is nice and composed, waiting patiently like a good boy. On the other hand, the younger dog can't contain her excitement. She literally can't sit still. And number two, the amount of food they're fed. We weigh out their food. Moki gets anything between 320 to 350 grams per meal, and Kobe here gets around 200 grams. We did used to feed Kobe raw food, and he got on with it really well, but Kobe's always had bad allergies. So sadly for him, we've had to put him on hypoallergenic food, which literally looks and smells like air. So, we do put some Greek yogurt and berries in it to spice it up a bit for him, and we did test these, and luckily, he's not allergic. Moki is on this Purina puppy food for large dogs. Again, we had her on raw, but we were literally feeding her about 1.2 kilograms of raw food a day when she was a pup, and you can see here, her metabolism was just too quick. So we switched to kibble, and she's been getting on with it really well. Kobe's still super excited, but you know, it's contained excitement. I mean, look at this good boy.
Wait. Can I get a paw? Paw? Oh, good boy. Other paw? Good boy. Yes, go on then.
Moki loses all composure. I'll tell her to do a trick, and she'll start doing every trick in the book just to get the food.
Spin, 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 spin.
But when she focuses, she's locked in.
Spin, down, watch. Yes.
Good girl. Good boy.
Oh boy, the next part of the day is always the most fun bit. The dogs have been walked, fed, and now it's time for me to start work. With Kobe, this is nice and easy. He's delighted with his morning. He's gotten everything he's needed. So now he's just going to sleep and rest like a good boy. Moki, on the other hand, just won't settle. Now this is partly because she's a Doberman and they've got no chill, but trust me, when Kobe was her age, he was bouncing off the walls too. So this is how it goes. An hour of work, nice and easy, then spend some time giving cuddles to Kobe. And Moki, on the other hand, 5 minutes of work, constant begging for attention, whining, then having to play.
It's hard to work with you just staring down on me like that. What do you want? You want pets?
We have got this crate for Moki, and I know what you're thinking, can't she just jump out of it? Well, yeah, but we trained her not to, and honestly, I think even she now believes that she can't. So the idea behind the crate is to give her her own place to chill out, also to try and teach her that now it's time to have a rest, not always annoy me. So into the crate, and now she'll settle. You wanna know why I'm recording her from here?
That's because as soon as I get close to this one, she wakes up instantly. Even though she's chilling, she doesn't really have any chill.
We're going to do something a little different for their afternoon walk, just to see if we can get the older dog to act a bit more like the younger dog. But first, 12 midday comes around, I take a break from work, have a quick play with Moki in the garden, Kobe will also get up and have a little wander around. And can't forget my absolute favourite thing to do, pick up dog poo. 3 p.m. hits and both dogs know it's their time to walk. Even as the dog gets older, the one thing they will always look forward to is their walks. So, we already know what they're both like on walks. Moki, crazy. Kobe, composed. But, what would happen if Ella took Moki on a walk, and me and Kobe would meet them halfway? Would Kobe then lose all composure? Ella began her walk with Moki, being her usual self and going nuts.
We visit this space every day, because she loves it that much. Come on. We're going to meet Kobe later. Come on, let's go. Leave it. Come on. Come.
We began our walk with Kobe, but we wanted to give him subtle hints that he was meeting Moki halfway. We've gotten Ella to drop Moki's blanket and one of her toys along the way.
We're now entering the forest. Of course, Kobe's got no idea that he's going to be meeting up with Moki. So let's see if we can get the older dog to act a bit more like the younger dog. So it's going to be interesting to see how he reacts to the little hints that we put there as well. I wonder if Kobe will catch on that Moki's close once he smells her blanket and her toy. Let's go find your sister.
Good boy. You do that toy look.
He's definitely picking up on her scent because he keeps smelling the ground and then running off.
Oh,
he smelled something.
Kobe, come.
He's found the blanket.
Kobe, what's that? Come here.
That's why he smelled, because he thought he could smell Moki.
Kobe, what's this?
All right, let's carry on. So Moki and Ella are literally down there, around that corner, and Kobe is fresh on their scent. There is another toy further down that he's just smelled. Oh, he's gone. He smelled them, he's gone. Wow, his sense of smell is amazing. So this is where the other toy was, but it looks like he didn't even need the hints. As soon as he got close, he found it. I wonder what his reaction was.
Who's that? Moki, what's that? What's that? Moki, who's that? Who's that? Who's that? Hello, gorgeous boy. Well done. You found Mama. Hello.
Let's see if I can get them to come back to me. Kobe! Moki! Come on, Mokes! Hello, little girl. Listen to me. Oh, good girl. Hello. Oh. And she's off again. Come on, Mokes! Come on, you two! Good boy, good girl. You find them, Cobes. Well done. And this is the young dog. And there's the old dog not chasing her. Old dog had enough. Got mission complete. I think we got the older dog to act a bit more like the younger. But you can definitely tell which one's the older, more dominant dog.
Yeah. Alright, so both dogs have had a quick nap. It's usually around this time the day finally catches up with Moki and she does actually get some sleep. It's time to feed them their dinner, and you know the deal now, 200 grams for Kobe and 320 grams for Moki.
You want some food? Spin! Spin! Lovely weather in the UK, as always it's raining.
Come.
So sometimes we'll feed Moki in this little covered area, because being a Doberman, she hates the rain. Ah, sit. Kobe, being a golden retriever, doesn't mind the rain.
Watch. Yes.
Speak. Speak. Good boy. Ready. Kobe, go.
Also, absolutely no food aggression with this one. You can do whatever you want to her.
And once again, absolutely no food aggression. Good boy, Cobes.
At this point in the day, Kobe's settled again. He's had his second walk, he's been fed, he's living his best life. Moki, she's the opposite. She's been fed now and she's ready to go again. So we will either do a little play with her or we'll actually take her on a walk around the block and practice some of her lead training.
And we're on the walk. What's wrong? So my auntie once said to me, if your plans depend on it not to rain in the UK, you'll end up doing nothing. So, rain or shine, we must go on.
Good girl. Moki Hill? Yes, good girl.
But like I said earlier, even an old dog loves his walks.
Go home, Kobe. Go home. Nah, go home. Well done, Kobe. Good boy.
Like I said at the start, Kobe loves his own space. So he's mostly chilling in bed whilst I catch up and watch some Netflix. This is partly the Doberman in her and her being a big baby, but Moki wants to cuddle up on the sofa with me, literally get as close as possible whilst we watch the best dog videos on YouTube in the world.
Moki, look, it's you. You watching yourself, Moki? Good girl.
We let them out for one last wee. Moki stays outside for about 2 minutes because she's a Doberman and she hates the cold. Kobe will stay outside and patrol a little bit.
Okay, sit. It's literally been 2 seconds.
And finally, it's time for them to go to sleep. Well, kinda. And if you enjoyed this video, YouTube thinks that the video popping up on screen right now is perfect for you to watch next. You may have a good time. See you there.